Fantasy VII Rebirth, a direct continuation of the remake, a game awaited for decades thanks to the overwhelming success of the original title released on the PS1 in 1997, has just been released recently on the PS5 and will be the subject of our analysis in this video. The game uses a customized version of the Unreal Engine 4, and in my view, despite being a very well-built game and artistically beautiful, we have seen much older games on previous generation platforms use the engine in a more advanced way with better graphical features. The game has two graphical optimization modes, performance and graphics. Regarding the game's performance, there aren't many criticisms to be made. It maintains almost 60 frames per second throughout most of the gameplay, with few drops. But dropping to around 40 frames per second in more critical moments in performance mode and running at a very stable 30 frames per second in graphics mode. As for the output resolutions used in the two optimization modes, where in my view, in graphics mode I identified 2160p, better known as 4K, and in performance mode 1440p. I didn't see any use of advanced upscaling techniques, such as FSR2, a feature that when used well delivers a better final result and also frees up processing to enhance features like geometry, shadows, reflections, etc. Regarding the game's geometry, there is a certain inconsistency in the environments, where we have very well-modeled elements mixed with others that are excessively low poly for the platform it is running on, or even for the previous one, in the case of the PS4. I don't have this impression with the character models, as they are very well constructed, although I prefer the models used in Final Fantasy VII Remake. Regarding reflections, the game uses cube map and screen space reflections, which in my view are already quite obsolete, especially cube map. We have seen games with much larger scope using ray tracing, and Final Fantasy VII Rebirth doesn't attempt this even in graphics mode, which runs at 30 frames per second, where there is possibly processing power to spare. And this feature, like all others from this point onward in the analysis, shows no significant difference, other than something related to resolution differences, between the available graphical optimization modes in the game. When analyzing the shadow technique applied in the game, in my view, a simple soft shadow mapping technique is used, and still very poorly implemented in my opinion, where they used a very grotesque transition between a more defined shadow and less blurred when very close to the camera, with a very blurred and low-resolution shadow when only a little further away, resulting in a strange, if not ugly, outcome. In my humble opinion, they should have used PCSS or at least should have left everything blurred. Regarding the quality of the textures, we have a situation similar to geometry, where we have textures in both high and low quality, but never terrible or excellent. However, on characters, they have a very good quality, matching the geometry. In conclusion, despite having a wonderfully artistic game with excellent story and gameplay, in my humble opinion, except for the characters, all other graphical elements, although very well executed in most cases, fall short in their final execution and could be much better, and even compared to the characters, the models from the remake are better. As for performance, the game is almost perfect, with occasional drop. Thank you very much.